Good afternoon, students. I welcome you all for the class. In this class, we'll be going to discuss another classical problem of synchronization, which is known as dining philosopher's problem. Fine. So this is another classical problem of synchronization. Why we are going to discuss all these classical problems in the sense, like when we are going to have, as I have said you already, processes are of two types: independent processes and dependent process, or else independent process and cooperative process, right? Independent processes are nothing but independently they'll be going to have the memory, own resources, everything on their own. They'll be not going to depend on another for their action. So they are independent of processes. We don't take that much importance for that independent process. But what the thing we have to consider is, we have to consider for the cooperative processes only. What do you mean by cooperative processes? Cooperative processes are the processes, something which is shared between the processes, we call it as a cooperative process, fine? Something which is shared, that something may be a memory, a variable, or a particular resource. That something is a particular resource or that thing. So if for that, if anything is sharing between the number of resources, then we have to take some importance for that resources. So if you are not going to take any of the importance for that resources, in the sense like we'll be going to get the race condition or we'll be going to get the deadlock situation, as we have already discussed. And today we'll be going to discuss another classical problem of synchronization, which is known as dining philosopher's problem. It is one of the concept in process synchronization. So what do you mean by a dining philosopher's problem? Let me explain you that what do you mean by a dining philosopher's problem. So the main concept of dining philosopher's problem is like five philosophers would be sitting around the table, fine, sitting at a rounded dining table, and the task of five philosophers is eating and thinking. If they are eating, that's it. If they are not eating, they have to think. If they are thinking, they should not eat. They'll be going to do either of the tasks. So only those two tasks are given for the five philosophers. And another important thing is, I'm in the dining table, I'll be showing you the diagram. So this is the table. So here, all the five philosophers are sitting over here, fine. So he is the zeroth philosopher, and he is the first philosopher, he is the second philosopher, he is the third philosopher, and he is the fourth philosopher, fine. And this is the first chopstick, it is the second chopstick, this one is the third chopstick, fourth chopstick, and fifth chopstick. So what do you mean by a chopstick? This is the pair of chopsticks. This we call it as a pair of chopsticks. So if between those five philosophers, only a single chopstick has been placed, not a pair of chopsticks. Only a single pair of chopstick has been placed. So if those philosopher, any of the philosopher want to eat, in the sense, he need to get two chopsticks, one and two chopsticks, then only he'll be going to eat that rice in the bowl, fine. But here, what is the thing here is, here not a pair of chopsticks has been placed, single chopsticks has been placed in between the philosophers, fine. Here is a single chopstick and here is a single chopstick. Suppose if five people wants to eat, in the sense, how many pairs we need, how many chopsticks we need? We need 10 chopsticks. But here, how many chopsticks are there? 5 chopsticks are there. So by making use of these 5 chopsticks, without providing any concurrency or any clumsiness between the 5 philosophers, they have to eat. So this is the dining philosopher's problem. So we have given the solution using semaphores. Suppose if 0th person wants to eat, in the sense, he has to get this first chopstick. The first chopstick he needs to get, and the second chopstick also he needs to get. Then only by making use of 1 and 2 chopstick, he'll be going to eat the thing. Suppose if third one wants to eat, in the sense, he needs to get this fifth chopstick, and he needs to get the fourth chopstick. So then only this fourth chopstick he needs to get, and the fifth chopstick he needs to get, then only he'll be going to, third person wants to eat. here there is no problem, we'll be going to find. First suppose if first person is eating and at the same zeroth person is eating, now the first chopstick is with zeroth person and second chopstick is with the zeroth person. So he is eating now, the zero person is eating now. At the same time when he is eating, this first philosopher wants to eat. Then he'll be going to first pick the left chopstick. The point here to be noted is, if any philosopher wants to eat, first he has to eat the left chopstick and then he has to lift the right chopstick. He should not lift right one first, left one second. So that is also one of the condition. First, which chopstick he needs to lift? First left one, and then the second one you have to use the right chopstick. So this is the order. First left chopstick he has to lift, and then second the right chopstick he has to lift. If only he can eat only whenever he is going to have both a pair of chopsticks, right? Suppose now the person zero is eating now, and at the same time the philosopher two wants to eat. Can he eat at the same time? No. Why? Because already the chopstick two is under the zeroth philosopher. Left chopstick is not there, only right chopstick is available over here. So this philosopher is not unable to eat that one. So that is how we have to provide synchronization among the five philosophers in order to eat a bowl of rice. So here, what we will be going to think is, here there is a bowl of rice, rice bowl is there. So do you think here, what we have to keep it in a critical section? Critical section in the sense, only one person should allow into it, the critical section, and then he has to release. So here there are two options. First one is the rice bowl. Should we keep rice bowl in the critical section? No, we can't keep rice bowl in the critical section. Why? Because suppose if person zero is eating, why? Because he has got the first chopstick and the second chopstick. So if person one is there in the critical section, zeroth person is there in the critical section, then suppose if third person wants to eat, if person three also wants to eat, in the sense he also can enter into the critical section, this person also can enter into the critical section. Why? Because he is also having the two chopsticks, fine. He is also having the two chopsticks. So he can also eat at the same time. So third person can also enter into the critical section. But what do you mean by a critical section? Only one process should be there in the critical section. So rice bowl we can't keep in the critical section. What we have to keep in the critical section is, we have to keep the chopstick in the critical section. So this chopstick has to be placed in the critical section. Why? Because if one chopstick is used by one philosopher, the other philosopher has to wait for that particular chopstick. So we'll be not going to keep rice in the critical section, but we'll be going to keep the chopstick in the critical section. See the conditions over here. So as I have said you, five philosophers are sitting at a rounded dining table. There is one chopstick between each pair of adjacent philosopher. The two tasks of a philosopher is, the first task is thinking and the second task is eating. Whenever a philosopher wishes to eat, she first needs to find two chopsticks. Then only she can eat the rice in the bowl. If only one chopstick is available, she couldn't, she's not at all supposed to eat. If she got the permission of two chopsticks, then only she is going to eat the rice. If a hungry philosopher does not have two chopsticks, he has chopsticks, what she will do? She will have to wait until both chopsticks are available. So that is the only solution. When a philosopher finishes eating, she puts down both the chopsticks to their original places and resumes thinking. After eating, what is the another task? They have to think. After thinking, what is the another task? They have to eat. Only two tasks are going to be done by the philosophers. There is an infinite amount of food on their plate, so they only need to worry about the chopsticks. So we have to manage the chopsticks. So here is, chopsticks are nothing but resources when we are going to talk in our language. chopsticks are resources and the persons are going to use those resources. Five persons has to use the five resources. So we have to provide simultaneous execution. We have to provide synchronization between those five philosophers. So that is the thing. So here as the chopsticks, as I have said you, these are the five philosophers sitting at the rounded table. Each chopstick is placed in between adjacent of each philosopher. So what are the conditions imposed on the philosophers? So philosophers are either thinking or eating. That is the first condition. They should not talk with each other. Philosophers can fetch chopsticks placed between them and their neighborhoods. Fine. Philosophers cannot take their neighbor's chopsticks away while they are eating. If one person is eating, we can't take away the chopstick from him and we shouldn't eat till he completes eating and till he, after he is kept that chopstick on the place, then only the other person has to take it. No forcibly taking of chopsticks. Fine. Hopefully no philosopher should starve. So as a person is keep on waiting, what is the condition? Starvation. We have seen in scheduling algorithms, right? If you are keep on waiting, we'll be going to have the problem of starvation. But here that starvation should not be occurred. So these are the five conditions. First condition is the philosopher has to think or eat. They shouldn't talk with each other. Second one is if they have to only eat when the two chopsticks are available. And the third one is the person who is eating, after eating only he'll be going to place the chopsticks at their original place. Then only the next philosopher who is hungry should take the chopsticks. So these are the conditions that are going to be imposed on the philosophers. So what is the solution? How we are going to provide solution for this dining philosopher's problem? So by making use of semaphores, we are going to provide solution for this problem. So semaphores, what we are going to use? We are going to use the weight and the signal. Fine. So weight in the sense it is going to decrement by one, signal in the sense it is going to increment by one, as we have seen in the producer consumer problem and the reader's writer's problem. So that is how the semaphores are. It is a variable. Semaphore is a variable or a synchronization tool, we can say also. The solution of a dining philosopher's problem is to use a semaphore to represent a chopstick. A chopstick can be picked up by executing a weight operation on the semaphore and released by executing a signal on the semaphore. Once a philosopher has picked up the chopstick in the sense, then we'll be going to keep awaiting. Why? Because already he has taken the chopstick. Next person who wants to eat, they has to wait. So that we'll be going to make that 1 to 0. 0 in the sense waiting condition. Once after completed this philosopher eating, if he kept the chopstick down, again from wait we'll be going to make it to signal. Signal in the sense 1. 1 in the sense the other person can eat the food now. So that is how we are going to make use of semaphore in the dining philosopher's problem. So this is the structure. So this is how we will be going to have the solution for the semaphores. Fine. Here the first it is a rounded table. Fine. So here the first 0th philosopher, here the first philosopher, here the second one, here third philosopher, and here the fourth philosopher. This is a first chopstick, this is the second chopstick, this is the third chopstick, this is a fourth chopstick, and this is the fifth chopstick. So how we are going to provide mutual exclusion? Mutual exclusion in the sense like only one should be eating at a time. Now we'll be going to make a semaphore array. This is an array of semaphore. So here we will be going to have 0th philosopher chopsticks. We are going to make semaphore for chopsticks. 2, 3, 4 and 5. 5 chopsticks are there. Fine. These 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 represents chopsticks. Fine. Not philosophers. We have created an array of semaphores for chopsticks. Fine. Suppose here, see this structure. do weight of chopstick I in the sense, suppose I equals to 1. Suppose the first philosopher wants to eat. So initially these all are represented with 1. Suppose if first philosopher wants to eat in the sense, what he has to get? Second chopstick he needs to get and the third chopstick he needs to get. So if first philosopher wants to eat in the sense, then weight chopstick of I plus 1 is 1 plus 1, that is 2. So we are creating a chopstick in a weight position and I plus 1 also. Why? Because he needs to get a 2 chopstick. Suppose if I equals to 0 in the sense 0 plus 1, that is equals to 1. So 0th chopstick he has to reserve as well as first chopstick he has to reserve. Suppose here 0th, 1, 2, 3 and 4. If 0th person wants to eat in the sense, what the chopstick? 0th chopstick, 0th person wants to eat in the sense, he has to get the first chopstick as well as the second chopstick. So this is how we will be going to create an array of semaphore. So by creating those semaphore array of chopsticks, we need to have the options, fine. So whenever we are going to create the chopstick option, so going back to our diagram, so here whenever we are going to keep an array of semaphores, right, here we have kept an array of semaphores. Suppose if 0th person or first person wants to eat in the sense, suppose for example, if first person wants to eat, then I equals to 1. Chopstick of I plus 1, that is 1 plus 1, that is equals to 2. So if person 1 wants to eat in I is equals to 1 in the sense, so he needs to get the 2 chopsticks, fine. So first chopstick and the second chopstick. So here we will be going to make this first chopstick and second chopstick for the first person, fine. So then when we are going to have, so now these 2 chopsticks are under reserved. So if person 3 wants to eat, which chopsticks he needs to get? Third chopstick and the fourth chopstick. But here when we are going to create an array of semaphores, whenever the 0th person is using, so he will be going to get the 1 and 2. Whenever the person 2 is using, he is to get the 4 and 3 and 4. Then we will be going to find no problem. If 0th person is eating, so we will be going to keep 1 and 2 with him. Suppose if first person wants to eat, we have to give 2 and 3 chopsticks to him. But 2 is already there with the first person. So we will be not going to, this first person has to think again. Instead of eating, he has to think again. Why this mod 5 in the sense? Suppose I is equals to 4 in the sense. 4 plus 1 is equals to how much? 5. So if fourth person wants to eat, which chopstick he needs to get? Fifth one and the first one. Suppose if fourth person wants to eat, he needs to get the fourth chopstick and the 0th chopstick, fine. But when 4 plus 1 is equals to 5, 5 mod 5 is equals to 0. So if 4 plus 1 is equals to 5 in the sense, actually we need to get the fifth chopstick. But fifth chopstick is not there. After 4, we are having 0th chopstick. In order to have that, when we are going to have the fourth philosopher, we are going to do the modulus condition. Why? Because the after 4, we are going to have the 0th chopstick. So for that purpose, we are going to have this modulus operator, fine. That is the thing. No, here the simple and very easy, if I is equals to any number of persons in the philosophers, 1 to 5. If I is equals to 1 in the sense, I plus 1, that is equals to 2. 2 mod 5. So 2 mod 5 in the sense, we will be going to get 2. So 1 and 2 will be under the control of this first person. Suppose if fourth person wants to eat, in the sense fourth person, 4 plus 1, that is equals to 5. So 5 minus 5 is equals to 0. So fourth chopstick and the zeroth chopstick should be with the fourth person. So this is how we'll be going to have the chopsticks arrangement. So when he got the chopstick, he is going to eat the rice. After eating the rice, signaling the chopstick I and chopstick of I plus 1, he has to release. When he kept down that chopstick, the other person is going to eat. So this is the condition when we are going to have this dining philosopher's problem. By making use of semaphores, we have provided a solution for this dining philosopher's problem. Why? Because only one person is eating at a time. That means mutual exclusion have been achieved. So we have to achieve the progress also. Progress in the sense, no deadlock should be there. Fine. For suppose this is a normal solution. For suppose if we think in another way. Why? Because first suppose now we have to consider I is equals to 1. I is equals to 1 in the sense. So first he has to pick the left chopstick. Fine. Or else a zeroth person if you consider. He has to pick the left chopstick. So he will be going to pick this. Before picking of right chopstick, I mean before when it comes to here, if there is a context switching in the sense, like we are allowing other person to eat. Suppose first person is going to eat, he has to pick the left chopstick. So this first person, what he done is, he has taken this left chopstick first. What this person has to do? He has to wait. Why? Because there is no right chopstick. In the same manner, when one is taking the left chopstick, in order he has to take the right chopstick also. In between, the second person has entered and has taken the right chopstick. So he is also waiting for the right one. In the same manner, third one is also waiting for the right one. In the same manner, fourth one is also waiting for the right one. So here comes the deadlock situation. Mutual exclusion by making use of semaphores, anyway we have achieved. So we have kept an array of semaphores for the chopsticks. So if anybody wants to eat, in the sense, for those chopsticks we are making it zero. Previously it was initialized to one, now we are making to zero. Suppose if second person wants to eat, in the sense, he has to get the first chopstick as well as third chopstick. So second chopstick as well as third chopstick, but second chopstick is already reserved, so he is not able to eat. So by making use of semaphores, we have achieved the mutual exclusion. But what I mean to say is, so if first person has to take the right as well as the left one, first person has to take the first one, left one and then the right one. So the first person has taken the left chopstick. So the first person has taken the left chopstick. When he is willing to take the right chopstick, the second person has taken the right chopstick. Fine. And when the second person is going to take the left chopstick, this third person has taken this right chopstick. When third person is going to take the left chopstick, this fourth person has taken the left chopstick. So like this, deadlock situation has been arrived. So there may be a possibility in that way also. We have to think in that way also. So a deadlock situation occurs. So when a difficulty with the solution, so what the difficulty I have said is, the above solution makes sure that, so what the solution we have provided with the semaphores makes sure that no two neighboring philosophers can eat at the same time. So that we have achieved by making use of semaphores. But this solution can lead to a deadlock. Why? Because if first person has to take the left chopstick, before taking the right chopstick, we have done a context switching. That means we have given chance to the second person. So second person also has to first pick the left chopstick. He picked the left chopstick first, but before the first person has taken the right chopstick, second person has taken the left chopstick. So the first person has to wait. Like that, all the persons are going to be waiting. That is a deadlock situation. So in order to avoid that deadlock situation, there are three solutions. So in order, some of the ways to avoid that deadlock situation are three solution. Why? Because suppose when we are getting a problem, if there are five philosophers, we are getting a problem. So the first solution is, if there are four philosophers only, suppose this fifth philosopher is not there. If fifth one is there, the first one will do its task completely, so that after eating he'll keep the chopsticks. When he kept the chopstick, third one can take that right chopstick and left chopstick and he can do, or else the second one can take the right chopstick and left chopstick he can do. So there is no problem of deadlock. That is, four philosophers we have to keep. That is the one solution. And the second solution is, we have to keep, instead of five, we have to keep six chopsticks. Fine? Along with the rice bowl, if you have placed another chopstick, in the sense, if anybody wants to eat, suppose a first person wants to eat, but this right chopstick is with the fifth person, what can he do? He'll be going to utilize this sixth chopstick and he can eat, so that there is no chance of waiting. So like that also, we are going to overcome the deadlock situation. So these are the two major ways in order to avoid the deadlock. The first one is, we have to make the four philosophers instead of five philosophers, so that nobody will be waiting. If one is waiting, one will be thinking, so that all will get a chance and no deadlock will be arranged. And second one is, instead of keeping five chopsticks, if we are going to keep six chopsticks, in the sense, so what will happen? Six chopsticks, in the sense, if the person who is not using that chopstick, the person who is hungry, he can use the chopstick which is near the rice bowl and he can eat the thing. So this is the second option. Fine. And the third option is, some will be keeping that even philosophers and the odd philosophers, like 2 and 4 are even philosophers and 0, 1, 3 are odd philosophers. Like they have divided, so depending on them, so 2 and 4 has to pick left and right, and 0, 1, 2, 3 has to pick from right to left. So that way also we can avoid the deadlock situation. So what they are telling here is, suppose first what they have to do, they have to take the left one and then they have to take the right one. They have to take the left one and they have to take the right one. So left one and the right one. So what the another solution is, the third problem is, for 0, 1, 2, 3, tell them to take left first and right second. But for the fourth person, tell him to take right first and left second. So left, right. So he has taken, left and right, left and right, left and right. But for the fourth person, first he has to pick the right chopstick and then he has to pick the left chopstick, so that a solution can be solved. So these are the some ways of coming out of this deadlock situation. So this is how we will be going to have a dining philosopher's problem to be solved. Fine. Dining philosophers, at a glance I am telling you, dining philosophers, in the sense, five philosophers are sitting at a rounded table. Fine. What is the task of the five philosophers is, they have to think either, or else they have to eat. Adjacent to each of the philosophers, one chopstick has been placed. If a philosopher is hungry, he has to eat. When he wants to eat, he has to get the two chopsticks. First, he has to pick the left chopstick and then he has to pick the right chopstick. First, he shouldn't pick the right chopstick. First, the condition is, he has to pick the left first and the right second. So that is the condition. So here, how we have provided solution, in the sense, by making use of semaphores. So semaphore, one array we have created. In that, we kept all the chopstick. All the chopsticks are initially one. That means nobody is used. When anybody is used, suppose the third person wants to eat, in the sense, three, which chopstick he needs to get, third chopstick as well as fourth chopsticks. So in place of 3 and 4, we make it 0. 0 in the sense they are already reserved. You, those who want to take the 3 and 4, they have to wait. So that for that purpose, we have created an array of semaphore, fine. So by making use of that semaphore, we have achieved mutual exclusion. But there may be a worst chances. That means if first philosopher has taken the left chopstick and if he tries to pick up the right chopstick, before that only the second person has taken the left chopstick. So what does it happen? The first philosopher has to wait. Like that it happens for all. So everybody is keep on waiting for the other chopstick. So it comes into deadlock situation. So how we are going to overcome deadlock situation is either we have to reduce the philosophers. That is the first problem. Or else we have to increase the chopsticks. That is the second problem. Or else we have to, what the third thing we have done is, what we have to do is we have to keep n processes are there, means n minus 1 processes we have to tell them to take from left to right, and for that one process, last process, we have to take from right to left. So that is the solution. So if those two solutions, the first and the second solutions, doesn't work, that means if we want to create, include another semaphore in the sense, it is very much costlier. If we don't want to change the statement, statement in the sense, 5 philosophers, 5 chopsticks, thinking and eating, no discussion between the philosophers. If one is eating, the adjacent fellow has to wait. So all these rules shouldn't disturb. But still I need to get in the sense, what the rule we have to do is, we have to keep the 4 philosophers left to right. First he has to pick the left one and then he has to pick the right one. But for the 4th philosopher, what we have to do is, we have to make him to pick the right one first and left one second. So this is the concept behind the dining philosopher's problem. Hope you had a clear idea about this, fine. So we'll be going to go with the next session by making use of this monitors, fine. So you just keep on keep practicing 1 or 2 times so that you'll be going to have the basic idea like what we have implemented in the dining philosopher's problem. It seems to be somewhat difficult, but it is very easy when you once got the concept. So what the concept in the sense, you have to understand the conditions first, then how to implement those conditions. If you got that, means like it will be easy for you, fine. Just go through once or twice in this so that it will be very much clear for you. And that's all for today's class, students. Thank you all. Have a great day.